Hi and welcome to my place. My name is Sylvia and this is Curupisa Crochet. Today I have a nice project, very easy and very quick to make. And it is this necklace that we've made with my daughter Lina. She crocheted this chain that you can see here since she was trying to learn to crochet. And then we added these beads and rings that I have made with plarn, that's to say with plastic yarn or yarn made from plastic bags. Today I'll show you how to make these beads that you can see here and the rings. You might know how to make the chain, but I'll explain to you anyways. Before we begin, I invite you to subscribe to my channel. I upload videos every week, mainly thinking about beginners and people who want to make projects for selling. Well, let's get to work. To start, let's check the materials we'll need. This is some spaghetti yarn or t-shirt dot yarn you use for the main part of a necklace. To work with this yarn, I used a 9mm hook that you can see here. The other kind of yarn that I needed for this project was this thin plarn that I got by cutting fine strips, thin strips of the plastic bags. And for that plarn, I used a hook that's thinner. It's a 2mm hook. Bear in mind that you might use another kind of yarn like this one that you can see here. It's an acrylic one. Use double in this case to get the same effect, or any other that you might like. And for the beads, you might choose some mercerized cotton yarn or any other kind that might suit you. Even though this project is easy and fast to make, you need some measurements. For instance, you need to leave a tail of about 10 inches or 25 centimeters. That's a tail where you'll place the beads and rings, and then we'll make a chain of about 25 or 30 stitches. After that, you leave another tail of unworked yarn. So we take the measure, and when we have it, we leave the tail of 25-30 centimeters and begin with a slip knot that you'll make by turning the yarn over itself and form a ring. Insert the hook and pull the yarn through that yarn ring. This is a slip knot. And then begin with the part where you will work the chain stitches. This part of the slip knot will help you get the beads in place. And then you'll begin working on the chain stitches. You know the drill. Just yarn over and pull the yarn through the loop on the hook. For the other necklace that you saw, my daughter changed 25 stitches, so let's get there and compare it with the one that my daughter made. Where is it? Well, you can see here that the spaghetti yarn that I use for the blue one is thinner than the other, so I need some more stitches. I guess it would be 25 more. With this yarn, you have to take care to get the stitches all to the same direction. Well, now it seems that I got the right measurement, so I only need to cut the yarn and close the last stitch so it doesn't unravel. And then I need to leave another tail of about 25 centimeters as I did in the beginning. And both yarn ends will meet in the back of the neck where I'll do some seaming and put some bead on top of it. Well, here you see I'm just finishing like this. You might want to make this project with your kids because it's very kid friendly. And now you can see I have the base where I will be placing the beads. Just insert them. You see the beads are rings that I will show you later how to make, and some tubes, some cylinders. I will place them randomly with no order, but if you are a symmetry lover, do it in a way that the same pattern is repeated on both sides. Well, once you've threaded all the beads, you have to remember to put one of these cylinders, this kind of bead, so you can slide it later on top of the seaming to hide it. Now I'll insert the other beads and then show you how to continue. So you can see here the necklace with all the beads and rings, and I only need to do the seaming that I show you later. Now let's make the rings. For this one you'll need to use this technique that I've learned while also learning how to do the Irish crochet techniques. You'll wrap the yarn around one of your fingers, in this case around your pinky, depending on the measure you want to make the rings. I wrapped about 12 or 14 times the yarn and did a chain, and now we'll make a round of single crochet stitches just to complete this ring. So wrapping around your fingers these many times with the yarn, you'll get a stiffness for the bead, and you only need to work on single crochet stitches until you get to the first stitch of the round that you see I just got there. So here you see this is one of the medium sized rings that I did. You might want to do it also with your index finger. You cut the yarn and pull it through the last single crochet, leaving a tail that you'll thread into a needle like this. And then you close the, you'll join the round like we did in other videos by passing the needle from back to front of the first stitch and inserting it again on top of the last stitch of the round. Then you'll weave the end by passing the needle through the stitches and then cut the yarn. This kind of yarn will allow you to do this very quickly, and you don't need to hide it many times and pass it to one side and the other. And there you go, you have your first ring. You might do it, as I told you, around your index finger, or maybe you want to make it smaller, so you might use your 9mm hook and the other hook that you use to work this ring and wrap the yarn around both of them at once. Both hooks will be looking to the same side, and then you'll push the hook you'll work with so you can start doing the first stitch, and then again do the same, just work in single crochet stitches around these and complete the work like I did with the first bead. Now for the tubular beads, we'll work in round also. Let me show you how. You start with a slip knot and a chain base. That chain will have the amount of stitches you'll need to get the size of the bead. In this case, I used 6 stitches. Join with a slip stitch the last stitch with the first one, and then on top of each chain work one single crochet stitch. If you have 6 stitches for the base, it will be 6 single crochet stitches. If you work 7 stitches, well, you get the idea. At first it will seem a bit difficult to work with this shape, but that this will be just for the first round. So you complete the round with the stitches you need and then join the last stitch with the first one with a slip stitch. Chain one to get to a second round and do the same again for the next rounds. So you see here, I got to the end of the first round. I will join the first and last stitch with a slip stitch. I'm trying to shape it up here. So let's go for the slip stitch. Now I'll clip the yarn tail from the beginning and then chain one for the next round and all over again. One single crochet stitch on top of each single crochet stitch of the previous round. And then continue working the same way for the amount of rounds that will allow you to get the size of the bead that you think is best. For the other beads that I showed you before, I did 6 rounds of single crochet stitches that you might see here if I focus well my camera.
I always seem to have the same trouble. For this piece, I also did 6 rounds of single crochet stitches, but for this one, I used another technique. I worked flat stitches. I started with 6 chains and then did 6 single crochet stitches for several rows and joined with single slip stitch the first round and the first row and the last one. Well, anyways, once you've finished working the piece, you leave this yarn tail, as I showed you for the ring. Thread the yarn in the needle and finish the same way with the same technique. You see this yarn tail passes through the last single crochet stitch. Then pass the needle from back to front. Then insert it again on top of the last single crochet stitch in here. And then weave it in. Since it's not possible to do it on the wrong side, I'll work it on the right side, passing the needle through the body of the single crochet stitches, and then clip the yarn tail. Well, now let's do the joining and finishing touches. As I told you, I used this kind of bead to hide the seaming. So let's pass the necklace base yarn through the bead. Open a bit this yarn that you used and place the other tail inside it and wrap it around the other yarn end. You might want to do this neatly, sew those ends, but since you'll hide them, you don't need to be that neat. And then you have your necklace. You see here this one I made using as a model the one that my daughter designed. Let's compare this one to the one that my daughter made, that I love very much and use very often. I really liked her idea. So I have a new set of necklaces to wear. This one is a bit thicker, as you can see. And well, you see, it's a very simple project. If you are careful and neat, you might make these kind of pieces to sell. Or you might use these as a weekend project to make with your kids. Well, I would like to have some feedback from you about this project. What you think? If you can make some hack to it, or if you would make it, or what other possibilities you can think. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you didn't already, and hit the bell to get notified of any videos I upload. And well, I hope to see you soon here, and that we can share some crochet time together. See you next time.